Out.
There we go.
Hey there, Crystal Covington, founder of Women of Denver, here chatting with Cathy O'Donnell, owner of Amen Packaging, about her family-owned business for 40 years and being a third-generation owner. And then we're also going to talk a little bit about some of the product shortages people are experiencing and what the heck is happening in the world. So Cathy, hello and welcome.
Hello, thanks for having me.
Awesome. So first off, I want to get a little bit of a story background about how you came to be part of this company, who started it in your family. What's it like running a family business? I'm asking a lot, so you don't have to spend like, you don't have to answer all of it, but just tell us a little bit about your background and the business that you work for.
So my grandpa started the business in 1979. He was working for some other container companies, and they found a need in the market, and they started as kind of a smaller niche in the business. And he worked until he was in his 80s, he and my grandma. Frequently we would see him asleep at the desk, but he just wanted to be a place where people could come and feel like they were appreciated as a customer, appreciated as we call them, a clients, and really form relationships and bonds with our clients. And we do have clients that have been with us for 40 years, that have not left. So client loyalty is one of the things that we really pride ourselves on. And I came into the business about 15 years ago. I was actually working in healthcare and feeling a bit of the burnout from that. And hiring in our industry can sometimes be a little different because the learning curve is incredibly long. So having grown up in the industry, they could, we needed another salesperson and they could hire me on with little to no training or learning curve because I grew up there. I spent my childhood counting caps and packing boxes and running around, you know, around what is now the Rhino Arts District, is where our building was. We just moved a couple of years ago, but that Rhino Arts District was basically where I spent my summers.
Nice. Yeah, I spent some time working in the packaging and labeling business back when I lived in Grand Rapids, Michigan, and I worked for a small, it was also family owned. And so it was a part of my learning experiences, understanding the basics of how things get packaged up. And I didn't realize how big of a deal it was and how important it was. It was like a serious part of the process for a lot of things that people normally buy.
Right. And so on our end, what we're supplying to people are, so if you were somebody who was manufacturing hot sauce, you wanted to put, your grandma made some awesome hot sauce and you wanted to put it out on the store shelves because it's the best. So you would come to us and we would help you with the bottle that you're going to put it in, the cap that you're going to put on it, the label if you want to label it, if you need a box for it. We also do in-house silk screening printing. So that's all done here locally in Denver in our facility. So if you are somebody that is like, I want to put this on a restaurant table and it needs to be able to withstand the dishwasher and be refilled, that would be something you'd come see us for. Or shampoo, or we have a lot of construction industry people, buckets and pails and paint people. So it is really vital if you want to put anything out in the industry that you have something to put it in.
Yeah, which brings me to another part of what we were talking about before I turned on the recording, was the packaging issues going on right now. So I did do a brief stint. I do project-based work, and I worked for, in the beginning of the pandemic, I was supporting a company that does, that helps small businesses that work for, that provide product on Amazon. A lot of them are smaller businesses, and a lot of their traffic is through Amazon. And we talked a lot in the content that we put together about all of the shortages and the backups and how people were ordering things and they weren't getting it. And so tell me a little bit about the part of what you all do that impacts that and how you saw the industry being impacted in product deliveries and shortages?
So there's a couple of things. A lot of components come from China or overseas, especially a lot of cosmetic components, a lot of multi-part components like sprayers, like your sprayer for your Clorox. That would have been something that was really impacted, and cleaning supply items are really impacted. And so we just don't manufacture a lot of that here in the States anymore. And when China shut down their part in the very beginning, those 8 weeks that they weren't really pushing things here, and we had boats sitting waiting for product to come in, we're seeing that lag. We started seeing that lag in probably May or June.
Okay.
In our side. Right now we have lead times on on items like that, sprayers and caps and things, into the 40-week time frame.
Okay.
Some, I have one sprayer that's coming in July of 2021.
Whoa.
Yeah. So when I say there's an impact, it's been an impact. Wow. For the general consumer who's looking for stuff on the store shelves, tin and steel have been tough because a lot of those mills are also located, especially tin plate. A lot of tin plate mills are located overseas. So the steel mills, we have some here, and we of course have some tin plate here, but we're starting to see that backup come in more early summer, where things are starting to get put on allocation. So like for us, we have items that we're only allowed to get so much of every month.
Oh, wow. There's little, all these things that we don't all think about. We just push the button on Amazon and we're like, where's my stuff? Why is it on back order?
Right. And like, I know I've got a ton of stuff on like subscribe and save. So it just shows up every month and I'll get these cancellations. And you know, toilet paper was a huge one. I don't think that's still recovered, but that kind of manufacturing pause leads into, okay, so we can't get Clorox wipes. So now we need something to spray because we need a cleaner to spray. Well, now we need paper towels because we can't just wipe with, we want to wipe the surface and throw it away. Yeah. So there's been a big impact just with when one item goes out, it trickles down to, you know, just one container of Clorox wipes made you buy two additional things to do the same job.
Oh gosh. Yeah. That puts it into perspective. So tell me a little bit about how people can, you know, keep in touch with you. What are some things you want to leave everybody with of, you know, how can we support you, be a part of your network, and, you know, continue to follow different pieces of advice and information that you have to share?
We have a showroom open to the public on 58th and I-25, the 38,000 square foot warehouse. So,
whoa.
So if you guys want to order, it's here, it's local, it's in stock. So a lot of the cool restaurateurs and businesses are changing the way they do things. So restaurants are offering drinks to go in jars. Come see us. We have them. You don't have to buy them from, we have pallets of them. So you don't have to worry if Walmart sold out of canning jars. We have them and a lot less expensive because we're selling them wholesale. Same thing if you've decided, again, you're a restaurant and you say, hey, everybody loves this special sauce that we put on our food. They can sell it. They have the commercial kitchen. There's a lot they can do with that. We work with fillers. We work with private labelers. We work with everybody. So especially we see this now when there's a lot of layoffs and there's a lot of people who are searching for alternate ways of income, that they start putting out their own products. And that's who we like. We love all clients, but we love to work with people who are starting out, who are excited about bringing this little ball of joy that they've had in their lives out to the world. And those are the clients we really love to work with those types of businesses too.
Awesome. I've seen a lot of that these days, and especially people making the pivots and trying to repackage and do things a little bit differently. So I'm sure they'll be giving you a call. Thanks so much, Cathy, for taking the time to chat with me today. I really appreciate your time and getting to know a little bit about your business and what's going on with packaging these days.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
Bye.
Bye.